The year 1995 is remembered for a lot of things. In the world of professional wrestling, the Monday Night Wars would begin as WCW Nitro premiered its first episodes. In the world of film, Clueless would hit theaters, and in the world of gaming, Sony would throw their hat into the race that was the console wars. Join us now as we look back at the year in gaming that was 1995. Nintendo would release the Game Boy Play It Loud series, which consisted of brand new color and clear versions of the Game Boy. Sega released the Sega Saturn in North America, debuting at number 3 in sales. Sadly, the NES would be discontinued in North America. Sony releases the PlayStation in North America, debuting at number 2 in sales. Sadly, they were unable to top Nintendo as the Super Nintendo took the top spot with 3.5 million more units sold. Just 400,000 more than the PlayStation and 1.4 million more than the Saturn. Virtua Fighter 2 would receive two Game of the Year awards, and Midway would rule the arcade scene with Cruisin' USA and Mortal Kombat 3 being the top grossing games, with the latter's console ports being the top selling games with 2 million more copies sold. On May 11th, the first E3 Expo is held in Los Angeles. Game FAQs would launch on the web as an archive of video game FAQs. Nintendo unravels a playable version of the Nintendo Ultra 64, which was later named just the Nintendo 64, at the 7th annual Nintendo Space World Software Exhibition in Japan. 13 games were demonstrated, but only two were playable: Kirby Ball 64 and Super Mario 64. New studios formed this year would include BioWare and Remedy. Nintendo would sue Samsung for promoting software piracy. The suit would be ultimately settled. Meanwhile, Nintendo of America would sue NTDEC. Other game releases included the likes of Mario's Pit Cross, Mega Man 7, Super Mario World 2 Yoshi's Island, Tekken 2, Battle Arena Toshinden, Chrono Trigger, which is in my opinion the greatest RPG of all time, Rayman, Soul Edge, Twisted Metal, Star Wars Dark Forces, Demolition Derby, Wipeout, and Jumping Flash. Westward Studios would release Command & Conquer, which would become one of the first popular real-time strategy games and spawns a successful franchise. Sega would release Phantasy Star 4, The End of the Millennium, which would be the final entry in the original series. Parallax Software would release Descent, popularizing the use of portal rendering technology, and provided the player with 6 full degrees of freedom. Nintendo would release Earthbound for the SNES, garnering a cult following. Blizzard would release Warcraft 2, Tides of Darkness, the sequel to their original real-time strategy. Rareware and Nintendo would release Donkey Kong Country 2, Diddy Kong's Quest, for the Super NES. Namco would release Time Crisis, and Nintendo would release the ill-fated Virtual Boy console. Well guys, that's everything that happened in 1995. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more content, and I'll see you next time when we revisit 1996. Later.